Last night, President Yoweri Museveni reiterated his earlier directive to fully open the economy, and today the entertainment and nightlife sectors, including bars and music concerts, will fully resume after close to 2 years of lockdown. Addressing journalists today during the weekly security briefing at the police headquarters in Nagulu, police spokesperson noted that while it may be hard for revelers to observe social distance and wear masks while enjoying themselves, the proprietors of these places should take responsibility and do routine cleaning.
In some of these social and entertainment places, the wearing of masks, social distancing, which is a requirement, is quite tricky. When people are dancing, it is very hard to observe social distancing in some of these nightclubs, bars and discos, but at least you should still ensure that you observe caution when you go to these places. You are aware that the reopening comes with the existence of COVID-19. We still have cases.
Enanga also cautioned those going to the bars and music concerts to desist from using Boda Bodas past 7 p.m. since the curfew on Boda Boda riders was maintained.
On movement of Boda Bodas is still on from 7 p.m. We shall be enforcing that restriction. So if at all you're going out, ensure that you have means to transport you back outside the Boda Boda. If you're going to go out and think that you're going to call a Boda Boda rider to come and pick you at 10, 11, midnight or 1 a.m., then you have to know that there are inconveniences and disruptions that come along with that.
Proprietors of entertainment areas and partygoers are also reminded that terrorism is still with us, so they should enjoy with caution.
So threats of terrorism that are still in place. Are you aware that we have enemies rotating around individual actors as well as small groups inspired primarily by the ADF? And some of these hangout places, discos, bars and so on, are soft targets. Although we've greatly disrupted some of these threats posed by terrorists, the challenge, the threat of terrorism remains present in our country, and we want to call upon all Ugandans and other citizens in the country to be as vigilant.
Meanwhile, the Deputy National Coordinator of Prevention of Trafficking in Persons, Agnes Igoyi, has disclosed that cases of human trafficking are on the rise, with some victims targeted for their internal body organs. This follows an incident of a one Judith Nachintu, whose kidney was reportedly removed while she was in Oman, where she had gone for domestic work.
And more has to be done, because Judith deserves justice. And exploitation, according to the prevention of this act here, exploitation includes removal of organs or body parts for sale or for purposes of witchcraft, harmful rituals and practices.
We want you to be kind to us and you let us expedite the investigations. Take note that this investigation is complex because it took place from a different jurisdiction where the suspects allegedly are in the other jurisdiction. So we are trying to harmonize and work through the protocols and have this case done in a manner that gives the family justice.
In other news, the Uganda Law Reform Commission has handed over a Braille-translated 1995 constitution to the Uganda Police Force to enhance access to justice for the visually impaired persons.
The transcribed constitution into Braille in fulfillment of this mandate of translation. And we are hopeful that this will enable access to justice, hence promoting the rule of law and administration of justice in this country. So, Director, I hereby hand over.
Transcribed constitution into Braille. Braille is for the blind. They just use hands, touch. And it is important because police officers also should know the rights, that people have rights, much as we're enforcing laws of Uganda. So even the blind have rights and the rest. So I'm happy to receive this group.
Rachel Nachuala reporting for the news.